the 20, and we're going to have snow today.
Oh, all right.
Because this is one of my snow days here. I was predicting we'd have 2 inches of snow, and looked like we're going to have it, too.
All right.
Of course, I'm getting ready to come your way, see?
I'd be here Wednesday.
Yeah, you're going to be there Wednesday.
Oh, yeah.
And we're going to discuss a little more about the weather down there, too.
All right, good.
I know everybody will be dying to hear about that.
Just excited. Excited.
I know. It's just hard to do anything with you. When you want to know about the weather, just call me.
If Fry Meyer says that a Banny Rooster can pull a freight train, hook him up.
Hook him up. And I got an interesting phone call yesterday. I had one gentleman. He wanted to give me an 8-foot-long boa constrictor. I said, man, I don't need another snake. I've got 2, maybe more than that, but they're cowsuckers. I don't want no boa constrictor. Can you imagine anybody wanting to give one of those? I wouldn't have that thing.
If I had one, I'd give it away.
He was on the right path. Well, I guess I better close for now, and I'll see you next Wednesday. And, folks, whatever you do, don't forget to crow today.
You take care of yourself.
I'm going to try to.
Bye-bye. Have y'all noticed how the phone calls have slowed down about the Christmas tree freshener? And we don't hardly get any more of those since the holidays. Wonder why. 1-800-572-8255. Talk quickly to Radio Ray in Madison. Good morning, big boy.
Good morning, Ludlow.
Happy Friday.
Thank you, and happy Friday to you, too. And, I talked to you Wednesday, so, and I told you something about my grandmother.
Yes.
Well, if you don't mind, I'd like to take time this morning to say thank you to all of the wackos, Bloody Mary, Bambi, Madam Zero, the Choo Choo Man, and lots of others out there who have sent cards to my grandmother. She's been ill, and she's been at the DeKalb Medical Center.
Right.
She's dying very slowly of Parkinson's disease.
Yeah, you told me that, yeah.
And it's been very, very tough for my mother and her brother, but we're all helping them get through this. And they're supposed to be moving my grandmother this morning to a convalescent home down on Peachtree Street somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
And they're doing that this morning. But I did check in with my mother this morning, and she's doing okay.
Oh, that's good.
She said to be sure to thank all of the wackos for their support and their prayers. And this has definitely helped her a lot, knowing that there are people out there thinking about her.
Well, we are thinking about it, and we wish your whole family good luck and hope you get through this.
Well, thank you. I'll be keeping up and let everybody know what's happening.
All right, big
guy. And also, Jim wanted me to ask you, if it'd be all right, if we could come up there on January the 20th, WYTH and broadcast live from 9 to 12.
I don't think you can help yourself, can you?
I don't know. You'll have to talk to Jim. He just wanted me to ask.
Bring some records and come on.
Okay. Have a great day.
All right, buddy. Be good.
Bye-bye.
Our number, 1-800-572-8255. Going to give you a chance to get caught up. Join us. Hi, this is Jim. To Larry on his car phone. Good morning, Larry.
Good morning, and Happy New Year.
And
a little belated there, but...
Never too late.
Never too late, you're right. Oh, I got a couple of things here on a catch-up. Number one, I'm glad I found you again. I'm glad your phone number didn't change.
Oh, no.
But I got a great bumper sticker that I saw.
What is it?
You've seen all the Save the Blue Whale bumper stickers?
Uh-huh.
I saw a Save the White Male. I almost run off the road when I saw that. That was funny. And a couple of other things. Christmas tree refresher formula.
Yeah.
I don't care about that anymore. Is there a Christmas tree taker downer refreshment formula?
Yeah, it's called Teenager.
Is that Teenager? No, it's not either. Not around my house. But anyway, I do know where you are now, so I'm back listening.
Hello, boy.
You're going to have to send out a mailer when this happens.
Easier said than done.
Yeah. But let's see, I have one more thing, and then I was going to turn it over to the rest of the crew. But I can't even remember what that... Oh, yeah, I know. Just a little quick tribute to a great movie star that passed away not long ago, and it's Cesar Romero.
Yeah.
And I got so aggravated at all the television programs saying, Cesar Romero, the Joker from the old Batman series, that man had a tremendous career.
Well, starting in the 20s, yeah.
Yeah, well, he went through 7 decades. He actually started in the 30s, early 30s, I mean, he was the Cisco Kid, I think one of the first ones.
Oh,
he
yeah.
was comedy, musical. He danced, he sang, he was a bad guy, and just, you name it.
Yeah, he was a lot more than the Joker.
And to show him in the green hair and the red lipstick, I just... that was pathetic. But anyway, we're going to... Another great talent we're
going to
miss.
Yeah, we sure are.
They're not going to be any more like him, I don't think.
Yeah, we spent the day talking about those folks that always, you know, never were huge stars, but always kept popping up and entertaining us all our lives. And Cesar
yeah.
Romero was certainly one of the tops.
Absolutely. And we got another great one that's going to celebrate his 87th birthday this year. An old cowboy star from the 30s, Bob Allen.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Bob spends the winters in Atlanta with his son and the summers back home in New York. And we always get together and watch one of his old movies every year.
Got to be great fun.
And he's still a very super gentleman. And my wife says one of the last of the gentlemen.
All right. Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah.
Isn't that great? I'm glad you called, big guy.
All right. Have a great one.
All right. Come by and see us.
All right. See you.
Take care. Covington, Georgia, and Betty on the radio. Good morning, sweet Betty.
Hello. How are you?
I'm great. How you
Good.
Doing?
I'm glad I found you. on Covington, we have you.
Good.
I have an answer to that real lovely lady that called in yesterday. Oh, she was a good speaker. She should write a book about the movie stars.
Yeah.
She liked Eddie Albert. She was trying to think, I think, of Brian Dennehy.
No,
I tell you
who it was. It turned out to be Ed Asner. Somebody called in.
Oh.
In that Christmas special.
Oh, yeah. I didn't see it, but the Brian Dennehy is such a good actor, and he's not really that old. I think he is in like 50.
He's one of my favorites. He's a good one.
He plays a mean type of person, and he can also. He was on a movie and played a real lovely person on that.
He's got his own series now, so we need to pull for him.
Oh, I sure will.
Yeah.
And he's got a lovely daughter that was on one of the soap operas for a while, and then she was bumped out by a girl that decided to come back on one of the CBS soaps.
I think we're going to see him become a real, real superstar, and I really enjoy it.
I
really
do, too. I love your program. Have a good day.
You be sweet, and I'll talk to you soon.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
1-800-572-8255. Want to talk to you about something that may be going on in your life. Somebody in your life? Sleepy all the time? Cannot seem to stay awake? No energy? Listless? Tired? Drops off to sleep in front of the television? When they go to bed at night, they snore like a son of a gun. I mean, they rattle the windows. Sleep apnea. That could be it. Matter of fact, that's probably it, because it's very common. Over 20 million Americans suffer from sleep apnea, and most of them don't even know they have it. Most of them seem to think that it's a natural thing to be sleepy and listless, and the ones that do know they have it or are worried about it have gone for a medical examination, and the unhappy fact is that a routine medical examination can't reveal the main symptoms of this illness because the patient's respiration remains normal while they're awake. Now, if something is not done, sleep apnea can develop into life-threatening health problems, things like personality changes, morning headaches, high blood pressure, a regular heart rhythm, some bad stuff. The husband or wife of the sleep apnea victim is normally the first one to pick this up because of this heavy snoring. Well, let me just tell you that there's something that can be done now. Sleep Disorder Center of Georgia. These folks are specialists in all types of sleep disorders. And what they have found out is that sleep apnea can be taken care of quickly, without surgery. It's not an expensive thing, but you need to call them and get the details. The area code is 404-257-0080. And a personal word to you ladies out there, you know your husband is not going to call. You just know that. You know how men are. We're bad to do that. So call for him, make an appointment, and drag him over there. You can give him a better life. Doesn't have to feel tired all the time. Doesn't have to doze off every afternoon in front of the television or go to sleep on the sofa snoring. Sleep Disorder Center of Georgia. These folks can help you. You give them a call. Area code is 404-257-0080. 404-257-0080. You tell them, I told you to call. You want to get all the information you can. These are good folks. Sleep Disorder Center of Georgia. Tell them I told you to call.
The cooling winds of winter are upon us, and there's never been a better time to make sure your furnace is ready to handle whatever Mother Nature has in store. If you're tired of getting up in the middle of the night to adjust your thermostat or waking up shivering, call Pyramid Heating and Air Conditioning today at 513-4101 and have your system winterized for only $49.95. For only $49.95, Pyramid Heating and Air Conditioning will perform its 30-point service check to ensure your home or office system is ready for winter's cold weather. Call today for an appointment at 513-4101. Pyramid's qualified, professionally trained service people will make sure your system is checked and cleaned thoroughly, so it'll perform at its best and save you money, because a clean system is an efficient system. Call Pyramid Heating and Air Conditioning today at 513-4101 and ask about their $49.95 winterizing service offer. That's Pyramid Heating and Air Conditioning. Call today, 513-4101. 513-4101.
Now 1-800-572-8255 as we talk to Detour on the radio. Good morning.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How you doing?
Well, just I'm having a surprising day already.
Well, good. A good surprising day,
I hope. Well, I don't know. I'm going to tell you.
All right.
I went in the backyard a little while ago to feed the birds, and I walked over to my neighbor's fence and was talking to their big black lab. And she looked up, and I looked over there, and I was within 4 feet of something. And I said, what is that? I said, that's the ugliest cat I've ever seen perched on that fence. And I said, no, wait a minute, that's not a cat, its tail is bare. So it turned and fixed me with a beady eye, and it was a possum. That's the first time I've ever been face to face with a live possum. So I sort of backed off, because I said, oh, hi. And I wasn't sure. I said, well, now, is it the possum that carries rabies? I know raccoons do. So I didn't know what it was doing there, and it's still sitting on the fence. And the birds won't come. They think it's a cat.
You know why? It's playing possum.
Oh, okay.
And as far as I know, they don't carry rabies, and it probably hadn't got enough sense to bite you if they did.
Okay.
So you don't have to be worried about it.
All right, well, good. Well,
that black lab doing? You think he'd be going crazy.
Well, that's it. And see, yesterday it did. It barked all day long, and I think maybe they have made peace with one another.
Well, you just got tired of barking then.
Or got tired, because it sat there and was not barking, growling, or anything. And so I don't know. I maybe they're friends now. It's very strange.
I think maybe the lab might just be dumb.
Or gave up. I don't know either. But I have never been that close. And I said, I hope this thing doesn't think I'm as ugly as I think it is.
See, he's supposed to bark at possums for a living.
Well, I thought so, too.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
That might have been what he was barking at yesterday. And then the thing, I just don't know.
You can pick that possum up by the tail and take him off if you need to.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Not me. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to stay away from it. But I've been as close to a possum as I ever want to be, anyway.
They are not pretty creatures.
No, they're not pretty, but at least I've... And I live kind of in the... Not in the city, but I live inside the perimeter, but I guess anything can hang out.
Oh, yeah. You're going to see possums everywhere.
Yeah, okay. Well, good. Well, anyway, that was my story. So far, the day started out kind of interesting, so I'll see what happens next.
Yeah, you see them everywhere, in cities, out of cities.
Well, I have never, I've seen them, dead, never face-to-face.
You're raised in this part of the country, and this is your first encounter with a possum.
Actually, yes.
Very interesting.
Yeah, all right. Y'all have a nice weekend.
You do the same. I'll talk to you.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Go to Cleveland, Georgia, and talk to my buddy, Punchy. Good
hey,
morning,
friend.
Punch. How you doing?
Pretty good, you?
Good.
It's foggy and rainy up here today.
Well, it's gonna be cold as a witch's watch fob tonight up there, too.
Oh, Lordy.
Yeah.
I can't stand that. Hey, I've just been concerned about the women that are getting into high places in government. I love the lady.
I know.
And I think that the best thing that ever happened to me was getting married.
Uh-huh.
I don't think I'd have been alive if I hadn't.
Probably not.
But, I've... I was in the infantry in World War II, and I can just imagine women in there with me, you know, at a time like that.
Yeah, you fantasize about it.
Going up over a hill, you know.
Yeah.
And the bullets cutting down the wheat like a scythe.
Uh-huh.
And I can just see me not helping take care of a woman in a case like that.
Well, your mama raised you right.
Absolutely.
See, your mama knew she was not raising a son. She was raising a future husband.
And a patriot.
That's right. And a great American.
Hey, look, and these women that this clown has put in high positions in government, I think they're bleeding our government white with this. This attorney general, this woman that wanted to legalize drugs, come to find out her son's on drugs. You don't suppose that happened?
It was not the attorney general. It was a surgeon general.
Surgeon general. That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. That's what I have written down here. Surgeon general. But
he was not on drugs. He was merely selling them.
Well, that's even worse.
He was an independent businessman, was he?
That's worse. I think a man that sells drugs to our young people should get a mandatory death sentence.
Oh, I don't have any argument with that at all. And I wouldn't care if the bailiff carried it out.
Yeah. I would like to watch it. I hadn't seen anything like that in a long time. And look, have a good day.
All right, buddy, you do the same and try to stay warm. I'll talk to you.
Thank you. Fine.
One and only Punchy. Stay with us. We'll be right back, gang. Enjoying this rebroadcast of one of my shows. Right now, let's get a weather forecast.
My exclusive 5-day forecast, overnight clear and cold, lows in the outer counties 20, in town 27, and then for Monday, increasing cloudiness in the afternoon with very low humidity, highs 45 to 49, lows around 35, and the extended outlook Tuesday through Thursday, a few scattered light showers Tuesday into Wednesday, turning partly cloudy Thursday afternoon. Tuesday's high near 50, low 42. Highs Wednesday and Thursday, 54 to 57, and lows 37. Recapping the forecast, overnight clear and cold, lows 20 to 27. I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the News Talk 750 WSB Weather Center.
It's 2:34 at News Talk 750 WSB. WSB color radar, it's clear right now. Current temperature here in Midtown Atlanta is 30 degrees. Good morning. I'm Bill Billings.
You're listening to the best of Ludlow Porch on News Talk 750 WSB. This is a pre-recorded program, so if you hear a telephone number, please don't call.
Gang, I'm Ludlow Porch. In charge of this entire production as we go to Greenville, South Carolina, and talk to Vince. Good morning, Vince.
Hey, good morning, Ludlow.
How you doing, pal?
Oh, I got a good one for you today.
All right.
Came up earlier in the week about building your own casket or a coffin, whichever you call that.
Yes.
And this is a very interesting subject. You might ask BBC about this. Ciro might want to comment on this. He's in the business.
That's true.
And I called mine the PCV. That's Personal Caskets by Vince.
Oh, okay.
And the reason I researched this subject, this came up several years ago, that I heard where there was a man that died that was real tall, and they didn't have a box to fit him in, so they just cut his legs off and moved him up a little bit.
Ooh.
And I wondered about that. And then I heard a case, you probably heard this one, where they were carrying the man out of the church and the bottom fell out.
Yeah, there's a big lawsuit about that.
Yeah, she sued the manufacturer. So I was inquiring about this. I called up five different morticians to find out what they had to say about it. Well, they were reluctant to talk about it at first, and then they made no bones about it. So I decided to dig into this to find out what all the pitfalls are, and you know, I left no stones unturned.
Uh-huh.
And they said that this is where their big profit is. And the cheapest one that most of them had that I could find was $749 per casket. Now, that's just a very cheap one. And, of course, they go on up to thousands from there. And this is the time in your life when you're most vulnerable to pay a lot, because they sort of find out what you can afford, and then they charge accordingly.
Well, plus, when you want to put somebody away, you want to show a little respect for them, and that's the way you can do it.
Yeah, it's very expensive, I'll tell you. And I asked around about this, and it seemed like that we had some guests here, and this subject came up, and it makes people laugh, and I don't really think it's funny, because it's really sad that they want to charge all that money for a box. I have a little shop. Now, I'm not in this business or anything, but I have seriously decided to make my own, and it costs probably less than $200.
Uh-huh.
You could have Formica on the inside and out. You could have stainless steel hardware, and you could make it custom built to fit. And then everybody says, well, what would you do with it? Where would you store it? You know?
Yeah.
And, well, there's no problem. We got a lot of stuff in storage. It's there in the storage shed. And you could stand it on end, make a bookcase out of it. Lots of different things like that you could do. But it just impressed me that there's so many times that when you get right down to it, death is about the most expensive thing that ever happened in your whole life.
Well, there's a point there, but that's how these folks make their living.
Yeah, that's what they said. Well, this one undertaker even suggested that I could make these and sell them to him, and then he could sell them back to my wife. You know, make a little profit on the way. But he said there's no law against it. You can make your own. In fact, you can get a permit that you could have your own little cemetery right in your own backyard. There's no law against that. You know, it can be done if you go to see the right people to do it.
Well, keep us advised as your research continues, Rick.
Well, I'm working on it now, and I'm going to make one custom fit.
Take care of yourself.
Okay.
Talk to you.
Bye.
1-800-572-8255, Carrollton, Georgia, and Mike. Hello, Michael. How you doing?
Yeah, fine, Ludlow. How are you?
I'm doing great.
Hey, I got a question.
All right.
Might be a trivial question.
All right.
Who the hell was Bob Seale? Wasn't he a cowboy?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right, I got something I'm going to send you. The Bob Seale comic book.
Oh,
send that up there to you.
Really? Yeah. You have seen Bob Steele. He's been in a lot of things since he stopped being a
Was he in Food Max the other day?
In what?
Food Max.
No.
There was this guy on a horse.
You remember F Troop?
Yeah.
He was Trooper Duffy in F Troop.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I got you. Okay. Well, that probably wasn't him in Food Max.
I wouldn't think so. I think he's passed away some time ago.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going through about 30,000 new books I've got, trying to figure out what I got in inventory and all that stuff. I just run across the old Blondie comic book. And do you remember Sergeant Rock?
Sergeant who?
Rock.
Sergeant Fury.
G.I. War. I got all kind of, all these things.
You may have some valuable stuff there.
Oh, I'm sure I have, and I'll probably got some valuable comics, too.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to run on, Ludlow. I'm waiting for a delivery. And I got to make sure that you know, the America's Most Wanted trucks have gone by already.
All right. You go get them, pal. We'll talk to you.
All right. You have a good day.
All right. Hang in there.
All right. Bye.
Sunnyside, Georgia, and Panhandle. Hello, Panhandle.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I've got something here that's similar to Out of the Mouths of Babes. It's not so much what they said, it's what they done.
All right.
My niece has a little four-year-old daughter, and she keeps her husband's sister's daughter, which is 4 years old.
Uh-huh.
One day, he decided to go to a store, something like Home Depot, and she said, well, just take the kids with you and give me a break. He said, okay. So they went to the store, and he went in the department where they have all the fixtures, mirrors and sinks and commodes and all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
He was standing there gazing at the wall, studying some kind of display, and he turned around, and both those two little girls had got on one of those commodes. And was he snatched those two youngins up and pulled them drawers up and hit it out the store, and what really topped it off, all the way out the store, his 4-year-old daughter kept hollering, but daddy, I didn't wipe.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah, I've heard that children will do that. When you get a children in a, and when they got bathroom fixtures, you better keep your eye on them.
Yeah, I expect he will. He said he won't. He won't be able to go in that store again. He feels like everybody's staring at him.
And they would be. Funny stuff, Panhandle. Take
all
care
right,
of yourself.
That's all man. I got this morning. We'll talk to you later.
Hang in there.
All right.
We'll be right back. Y'all stay with us. And with quick and sure punishment. That's part of it. But the punishment's not all of it either.
No, you're right. You're right. But I just, this to me, is it's a I see this as a trendy thing that frankly accomplishes nothing.
Well, but it gets publicity for a lot of people.
Sure it does. Sure it does. But mainly what I wanted to call you about was this. Did you happen to see Connie Chung's show last night?
What was it about?
About political correctness.
Oh, yes. Night before last, yeah.
No, I'm talking about the one that was last night.
Well, no, I didn't see the one
maybe, I'm sorry, maybe it wasn't Connie Chung's. It was,
I saw 48 Hours. I was on 48 Hours.
Okay, well, then last night, whatever the other newsy kind of show was last night.
Prime time, yeah.
Did you see that?
No.
But what has the world come to? There are, get this, several newspapers have canceled Beetle Bailey for political incorrectness.
Yeah.
You've heard about that.
Yeah, I knew that he was in trouble. What about the Oriental guy?
Well, it's not only that. Not only that, it was.
I don't think I'm supposed to say Oriental anymore. I think
no.
It's Asian, then.
Well, I don't know.
What is it this week?
I don't know. According to the guy from the night before, you know, dead people are what, living in pairs or something like that. But they said last night that now get this. Fat people are offended. Now, I happen to be a fat person. But they said fat people are offended because some of the jokes in there were about, you know, about fat people.
Yeah.
Secretaries are offended because a couple of the, they showed this thing where a couple of the panels were about a secretary.
Yeah, dumb secretaries, generals. But that's been going on for 25 years.
I understand.
The secretaries must be dumb. It took them a hell of a long time to get offended, didn't it?
Yeah. And then they had this farmers group that's unhappy because that guy, you know, Zero or whatever his name is, came from a farming background. He's an idiot. And then, let's see, who else? Let's see, farmers, fat guys, Asians. I guess that was all that they talked about last night. But, you know, the biggest group that they missed altogether, and I guess these people are so slow that they don't understand that they're supposed to be offended, is the military.
Either they got to recognize the truth in all of that. I don't know. I've said this 100 times, Larry. And I used to have it over my door, over my office door. And it was a sign that simply said, Lord, save me from the humorless people of the world.
That is exactly what I was getting ready to say. I remember I've heard you say that a number of times. And, you know, some of these people just have too much time on their hands, I think.
Anybody that's offended by Beetle Bailey has got hairy thighs and don't love the Lord.
Where have we come to? Where have we come to in this world where Beetle Bailey... I mean, if Beetle... This is what gets me about this. If Beetle Bailey is politically incorrect, can you find anything in this world that is not politically incorrect to hear those people tell it?
No, you can't.
No, you can't.
You really can't.
It's time to move on.
Yeah, to hell with them.
Lud, have a good new year. Haven't talked to you since last year.
You take care of your bad self. I got to go, big boy.
Okay.
Hang in there.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Beetle Bailey, politically incorrect. Don't you love it? You got people being murdered by the thousands, I say. You got high school graduates who cannot read their name or find their fanny with a 10-man working party. You got teenagers, instead of going to proms, they're killing each other. You got an out of control illegitimate birth rate, and folks are spending time and energy worrying about Beetle Bailey. I can't hardly stand it. 1-800-572-8255. I want to tell you about some friends of mine who are set up to help. Let's go now. To the castle and talk to one of the classiest broads I know, the princess. I'm sorry.
Excuse me.
I'm sorry, princess. I was making a stab at being politically incorrect.
I was going to say, I thought we were...